In this video, I want to quickly show you how to use that program to make the quadratic Koch curve, which was part of the test for Unit 1. And remember, the rule here for this variation on the curve is that a line segment like this is replaced with one that bends up and then down. And so each of these little line segments is a quarter the length of this one. And there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 such line segments. So let's see how to do this on the computer. And I'm showing you this both because it's a pretty neat looking shape and also because it illustrates a subtlety with the piece of software. So let's give it a try. So here's the program again. And I'm going to go down, click on Snap to Grid, and we're going to need a total of 9 points. There they are, 9 points. So what I'll do next is I'll position these so that it does the rule like we would want. Almost done. There. Okay, so now if I go up in iteration, I see that shape, which is pretty neat. There, there, and I'll do one more. So this makes a nice, I think it's a nice fractal, a little more interesting than the Koch curve maybe. But the thing that I wanted to illustrate is that this point here is essential because we want this line segment here and that line segment to both be replaced by this smaller piece. So let's see. Right, so this line segment here is replaced by the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 little pieces, and the same thing happens in there. If I were to make this shape by using only 8 points and not having this there, this then would get treated differently. It would look cool, but it wouldn't be exactly the fractal that we had in mind. So, in any event, that's how to make the quadratic Koch curve. It's another appealing fractal. And because I can't resist, we could also change this up in different ways and get all sorts of different shapes out of this simple iteration.